Hello everyone. Welcome back to the campus of Blenko Glass in Milton, West Virginia. This morning we showed a couple of the steps and process to making a special piece, and this is the piece we're making for the Festival of Glass this year, a tribute to our neighbor glass company, Pilgrim Glass. It closed in 2002. A crystal to turquoise fade, a giant piece of glass. We also have, as festival pieces, this is the merchandising pitch. We have a poster, which is limited and numbered edition of 100, by local artist Ian Bodie. We think the style fits us at mid-century all the way. Bright, bold colors. You've seen the glass blowers, the furnace, water bottles, of course. So, posters available. And what we're going to make live for you this afternoon is this piece. This is in a kind of a remodeling of a classic Blenko form designed by Winslow Anderson. It was 967, I believe, was the original wear number. We're going to make it in turquoise with pawpaw and crystal with pawpaw as a special piece just during the Festival of Glass. So, but the most important thing is we're going to take you inside now to watch it made. Usually our Festival of Glass is when we invite you to come to our campus and do activities and hang out with us. This year, because of COVID, we just cannot do that. So we're all masked up and goggled down, and it's hot here. Probably best you're sitting at home. But we're going to walk you through the steps in making this piece, which is our festival piece for this year, okay? As always, thank you for supporting Blenko. Glad we're here. And right now, we're going to go live to the shop floor where the guys are already making this piece. Thank you again. As we walk in, they're finishing, or nearly finished, with making one of the pieces, this picture, our tribute to the 967. You can see Randy, who is a master finisher, setting a handle on a piece, a glass, again, about 2,000 degrees in liquid. Kind of checking the angle of it there to make sure he likes the way it looks. Jordan is standing by to carry it into the lair. Randy straightens the handle just a little bit, looks at it to make sure he likes it, and he's going to crack it off now. Just a little tiny bit, and that's how we get our ponto, that break. Jordan carries it over where he will polish the ponto just a little bit with fire. We don't mechanically polish them by grinding. We use fire to take off that sharp edge. So that's what Jordan's doing for right now. And he's content that the ponto is not a danger. It will go into the lair for about a 4.5 hour ride. Okay, now let's come back here, and we're bringing a piece. Timmy's bringing one over from the furnace where he's made his gather. He presents it to the master blower. Perry, in this case, is the guy in the chair. Perry, one of our most accomplished glass workers, among many. So he's rolling back and forth in a wooden block mold to give it its initial shape. Wooden molds are made on site out of cherry wood and dipped in water to keep the mold from burning up as quickly. So there's a layer of steam and carbon there that the glass rides on. We would tell you that that helps make our shapes and our finishes very special. He uses a wooden paddle, also made of cherry, dipped in water. As he rolls it back and forth, he's pushing that bubble down just a little further off the pipe. Little puff of air, and he wants very much to have it down to a temperature that he sees in the color of the glass as being the right temperature. Something the rest of us have no idea what that means, but he's watching the temp. Continue to blow the bubble and shape of the paddle.
Another puff of air. He stands up, letting it cool just a little more. He uses his pinchers to put a little neck in it. Up the steps he goes, and there's a wooden mold there. Down into the wooden mold we go. As he blows, the steam from the water and the smoke from the burning of the wood create that little layer on which the vessel rides. When he's done, he'll tap 1 foot just a little bit, and the mold person will know to open it up. He's flattened it on both sides a little to give it the shape, so it's not perfectly round. We blow it symmetrical, and then he flattens it again, putting a neck on it. Paddle it to the bottom to make sure that it's got a flat bottom. We want to set, you see a little smoke coming off there as the hot glass burns the wood. Thermal shot now by adding a little water to the neck. Water hits the glass and creates a the beginning of a fracture in the vessel as we have blown it. He's waiting now for someone to come running with a punty. Chris has got the punty. This is where that ponto mark or punty mark comes from. He will stick it up on the bottom. A little more water and a gentle tap should release it. So we've used a thermal shock and a actual physical shock to release it. We carry it over back into the glory hole. Glory hole is where the fire burns, not to melt the glass, but just to keep it malleable. Chris is taking it in there, getting it hot again around the top so that Randy, the finisher, can pick up where we saw him a while ago and complete the finishing of the object. You know, it's really hard to tell who's who here without the mask on. Everyone's eyebrows look the same. Chris is watching to see it. Certain color in the glass, which will indicate to him that he's got it hot enough. He's put his hand up there. If you notice, there's a vent above him blowing air on him. Timmy comes in and gets a pipe to go get again another piece. So we haven't finished this one, but Timmy's going back to make the gatherer for the next one. So that's in theory how rapidly in succession we create them. Chris is now believes he's got it hot enough for Randy to finish. Randy just tools the neck and opens it up wider, shears it with his shears, and cut it. Glass, when it's hot, cuts very much like leather. Putting the pouring spout on it right there. Back to the fire again. I'd like to remind you to both like and share this video. It's always good for us. It helps the circulation and how many others will be redirected to this or be made aware of it. So if you can, like and share our videos. Randy's pulling it out now, letting a little bit of gravity do its work to pull down the top of the glass. Uses a hand tool to put a little bit of a pouring spout on it. We've tested these for pouring. We've made some beautiful pictures over the years that didn't pour well, but this one pours quite well. Uses a piece of chalk to make a little mark on there where he wants to set his handles. So he'll have a kind of a target to go for. That mark will wipe off later because the glass is cool enough by now, it'll just sit on the surface. Justin's got a gather. Touch down on the vase, or actually the vessel, which you're about to be. Pulls it up. Randy decides how long he wants it. That's how much glass he needs to make this handle. Pulls it over, touches it down, pushes it against the body to make sure that it's making a good cohesive contact, a good solid handle. Now we go back and add the aesthetics with a little bit of curve. This is where the artisan and the craftsman comes out. One nice gentle curve there. The handle on these are going to be tall, but the vessel itself will be crystal. So even though it's orange now, it will stay orange. Almost everything we make is orange or red when we make it. That's a common question from visitors is, do you make anything besides orange or red glass? We do not make anything besides orange or red, but once it cools down, it becomes something other. And again, Jordan's taking it, a little bit of shock right there, breaks off. Jordan will go back again to the fire, where he will polish the punty instead of grinding it. And I don't know exactly what you're seeing, but here comes Timmy with the beginning of the next one, as one of them is going over to be put into the lair, where it's 4.5 hour ride to annealing to remove stress so the glass won't blow up. As that happens, going one way, Timmy's bringing another big gather the other way to start the next one. Again, Perry Master Blower, wooden hand tools, handmade on site of cherry wood. And this is the skill in a hand-blown glass, to know how much glass to gather. Too little, we don't have enough for the pitcher. Too much, it's big and thick and clumsy. These puffs of air, he'll inflate it just a little bit. Let it cool a little bit. He's trying to make it into the exact state where he believes it will retain the shape he wants to give it. So a little air, a little cooling, a little air, a little cooling. And this is where the 40 years of experience that most of our glass workers, many of our glass workers have, will come into play. 30 to 40 years of experience. It looks easy when they do it. It looks really easy when they do it. But trust me, as you notice, he keeps turning it to keep the gravity from taking the glass off his pipe. Even that little simple step of just keeping the glass on the pipe is hard. Up he goes. Mold boy will open the wooden mold. Down we go, turning it again, creating that layer of steam and carbon, the burning of the wood and the water on which the glass will ride. Therefore, no seams or mold marks in our glass. And we like to think an outrageously great polish on the sides from that steam and carbon. He's flattened it a little bit, goes back to his bench again, pinching it down some so that it'll be a smaller neck and he can break it off, paddling the bottom to ensure a flat or as near as flat as possible, maybe a little pushing it up in the middle to give it a little bit of a, in other words, concave base, water. He's now waiting and looking for his punty. Chris is coming back again with the punty, a little bit of glass on it. This is the, again, punty mark or pontal mark. Touches it down and water and shock. And there we go. The vessel is now blown. So we're taking it back to the finisher, Randy, his team. Chris is going to go back into the glory hole, heat to make it soft. But keep the glass malleable so we can continue to shape it this whole time. So that's what he's doing right now. And as he's doing that, Justin reaches in, takes out the pipe to begin the next one. So long before this one's even done, we're starting the next piece in the production line. Normally we make three different pieces at a time here. We run three shops, and we're watching the interaction between one shop. Usually we're 5 or 6 men on a piece. There are a few pieces that require many less, and a few that require more. But our average, the composition of the average glass team is 4, more likely 5 or 6 people. Chris, in his official Blenko Festival of Glass t-shirt, got it where he thinks it's hot enough at the top. Back to Randy, the master finisher, flares the top out just a wee bit. Takes his shears, cuts the hot glass, which is always an amazing thing. Off goes the glass. Back we go for heat. We have to keep it really hot so we can continue to shape it. Again, the fire that Randy's staying from now is called the glory hole. It is only fire. There's no glass or anything there. It's just a big roaring fire to allow us to keep things hot. Hand tool to set his lip, pouring spout on the pitcher. Hand tool, again, he tidies up the cut to make sure it's symmetrical as he likes it. Marks where he's going to set his handle. In the meantime, Justin is here with that gather for the handle. And a while ago I said Justin was starting another piece, but He actually had a gather for a handle. Touch it down to the body. Pull it up. The Randy thinks he has the right amount of glass. Cuts just and loose. Use a little bit of gravity to pull it out. Touch it down. Push it against the body. It'll cool just a little bit now. Using that motion of rolling it back and forth so it doesn't sag or fall. And then that artist hand again to give it the graceful handle we like so much on our pieces. Jordan standing ready. Randy making certain he likes the angle of that handle a little bit. Jordan will get ready to pick the piece up. Tap, tap, and off it goes with rough ponzo on the bottom where the punty or the ponzo rod was. Jordan's carrying it over to the fire. He will hit it with a flame on the bottom, smoothing that out, and that will end our piece.
Let's end your narration. Tell him to like and share and close out. We're going to keep going, but we're going to end your narration.
Okay. I'm going to step away from being the narrator for this. We've walked through two pieces now. We're going to keep making them and keep filming, so watch us. And don't forget to like and share this, please. We appreciate your support of Blenko as always. Happy Festival of Glass. Like and share. Thank you.
down for a minute. Shut your phone off. Sorry. Close.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for waiting for us. We are getting back to work here. We're watching another shop right now make some candle holders. Here in just a moment, we're going to kick back to watching the other teams make our Festival of Glass pitcher. You might even see, and I see a couple comments I've already spotted, making some pumpkins, getting ready for fall. So if you have any questions, please, please, please do ask in the comment section. We will get to them if we can. I really appreciate you all. Wish you could be here with us. Hoping this digital version is good enough. Cutting back and forth between the pumpkins, the candle holders, and the festival glass pitcher. So y'all hang tight. If you have questions again, ask us in the comments.